On today's video, we're going to go over how to start the engine of a Cessna 172 G1000 with the GFC 700. We're going to be following the POH, and you can find it on our website, aviator.nyc. This is a three-part series of videos that we're going to be doing to help students who want to get the most out of their home flight simulator and practice to make their flight training more efficient. So here we are at the simulator here at SimTech Aviation. The first checklist we're going to do is starting engine checklist. Throttle, 1/4 inch, open. So one of the common mistakes that we see people do here is they will do 1/4 travel on the throttle, when in reality, all you need is 1/4 inch. The throttle really controls air, how much air is going to go into the engine. Mixture, idle cutoff. Mixture is the red knob. Generally in aviation, red is bad. In this case, red is fuel. And bad things happen when you go all the way back because you're actually closing all the fuel going into the engine at this point. Standby battery switch. The switch is located generally here on the left side of the airplane. It's a 3-point position switch. So you will test it. The green light will come on. It will stay on for 10 seconds. And then you'll go into the on position. Because we don't have a standby battery, I'm going to turn the battery master switch on. The primary flight display comes on and is the PFD. And sometimes you'll hear us referring as such. Here's a warning. So what we're going to do is we will look over what the warning is. We acknowledge that there is a warning by saying something along the lines is associated. I would also look over the advisories and know that that is related to that we're getting ready to start the engine. And all these enunciators are normal when the engine is off. Then we're going to continue with step 4, which is engine indicating systems. Engine indicating systems. The engine systems are here on the left, and we're looking for no red X's. As of now, we'll see that we have a red X, and this is what you're looking for. Make sure there's no red X's on the oil pressure. If this happens in real life, you actually will have to write it up and go to maintenance. But because we're in the simulator, magic happens, and it goes away. Now, we'll continue on. Bus E, check 24 volts minimum. That's going to be talking about the electrical system. Electrical system is on the left, bottom left. And we'll see bus E 23.8. That is normal. It's because we have the battery running. Bus M, check 1.5 volts or less. So in this case, it's showing 24. The reason for that is because we have the battery master switch on. If we just had the standby battery, which we don't have in a simulator, but you actually do have a standby battery in your flight home flight simulator, it will show 1.5. Battery S, check discharge, which we do have. Standby battery enunciator check. This is the enunciator, and we do have the enunciator battery on. Battery master, master switch, alternator and battery, that switch is located here. I'm going to turn the alternators to follow the POH. Then that note, you will see different procedures in different airplanes. So just make sure you follow the most up-to-date copy of your pilot operating handbook. Beacon light switch on. We'll turn the beacon on. The beacon is a red flashing red light indicating that the engine is getting ready to come on. The note is going to be talking about priming the engine. People that are not very mechanically inclined, priming the engine, all it means is that we're adding fuel to the engine in order to get it started. And that's what the next procedure is going to be. Well, one important thing to note here is steps 1 through 14 should be done almost by memory and understanding the procedure, because two things will happen. So now, we'll read the procedure to explain it. Fuel pump on, mixture control set full rich. This is the mixture, and we said before, it controls the fuel. And then we'll cut it off between 3 to 5 seconds. And we know that is because there's a carrot up here, this little white carrot will start moving. Once it stabilizes, we start counting. And then we will bring the mixture cut off and then the fuel pump off. We are getting ready to introduce fuel to the engine. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the fuel pump on, mixture full rich. I look at the fuel flow gauge, 1001, 1002, 1003, mixture cut off, fuel pump off. All in one procedure. The next step is magneto switch start. In real life, starting the engine, it's a little bit more painful than what it is in simulators, but it does help you to get the idea. You also, in the real airplane, you'll have the sound and the vibration of what the engine's doing. In the simulator, we just have the gauges and the engine sounds from the simulator. So at this point, I will open my window and I will yell clear prop, and I will scan the area, make sure there's nobody that could get hurt with the propeller. I'm going to halt my feet on the brakes. I'm going to go right magneto, left magneto, both. I'm going to place my right hand on the mixture. And the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to select start, and I'm actually going to hold it until we hear the engine firing. Firing meaning that the engine's starting. So here we go. There's start. I can hear the engine turning. I'll introduce fuel. Right away, I'm going to go to my throttle. I'm going to set as close as I can to 1,000 RPM. Make sure that the oil pressure is in the green. I'm going to make sure my alternators, and this is an airmanship item. I turn my avionics on at this point. And then we'll go back to the checklist. Magneto's engine start, mixture control, advance smoothly, which we did to rich. Oil pressure checked. Battery M and battery S check and make sure that we are charging and that we have no annunciators. Nav light on and avionics master on. We complete the checklist by calling, by saying starting engine checklist complete. If you did find this video useful, please like and subscribe and visit our website, aviator.nyc, for other blogs and more information regarding flight training.